Military bands and the heads of state, Victoria Brezhnev was invited to come and have a last viewing of her husband's body before the casket was closed and taken to the cemetery. She was not allowed to say anything. She was not allowed to be a part of any of the ceremony that had preceded this one last moment. But she was going to be offered this singular moment to go up and view her husband, and then the casket would be closed. Vice President Bush was about six people away from her, and Victoria Brezhnev walked up to the cabinet, walked up to the casket, looked at her husband's body, and made the sign of the cross. George Bush says even today, it was that act in the epicenter of communism and official atheism and totalitarianism, the greatest act of civil disobedience he has ever witnessed in his entire life. He tells that story to basically make the point that even in the darkest places, faith can arise.
Amen.
And sometimes you and I may find ourselves in the hard, dark seasons and places of life. But when we're down to nothing, God's up to something. Because His roots are infusing a stump that's going to produce a sprout that's going to give a branch. And you and I have a confident expectation this morning because of the character and the promise of God.
Amen.
We're going to do something a little different to close our service today. Normally we stand and we sing a closing song. I'm going to invite Maddie to come up. She's going to sing. And she's going to sing about Emmanuel. You're just going to remain seated right where you are. Maybe you're in a stunned moment of life. Maybe you're in a hard place. And you need a chute to come up out of that seat. You need to feel life, or there's death. You need only what God can give. That confident expectation. And when we're down to nothing, He's up to something. There's no darkness that can hide that, can defeat that can overcome that. Because in Advent, we are reminded that the hope is Emmanuel, God with us. So as Billy sings,